जैन स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वेलकम वंस अगेन टू लाइव सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड द प्ले वेयर वी लेफ्ट द प्रीवियस डे। एंड फॉर दिस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द टेक्स्ट विद यू। Please wait a minute. Here it is. Now let us see, children, that where we had left. So we were here somewhere. That tin doesn't hurt, boy. Does your leg hurt? You know that while he was talking, when I am here, not only one but the world. As much as anywhere, Mr. Lamb was trying to change his opinion towards life and people, to adopt the positive attitudes towards life and people. And when Derry asked, "Do you think this is the world, this old garden?" then Mr. Lamb told that your opinion may be different, but according to him, that when I am here, when he was there in the garden, so not only one, that he was not only one there, rather, but the world. But he is surrounded by the world. He is surrounded by the beauty of the world as much as anywhere. And then Derry changed the topic, and he asked that, "Does your leg hurt you?" Because he knew that he is also disabled like him, that he has a tin leg. So that's why he wanted to know whether his tin leg hurts him, pains him or not. "Tin doesn't hurt, boy." Then Mr. Lamb said that tin doesn't hurt. Doesn't give any pain. Means actually this is his displeasure. Actually this is displeasure of Mr. Lamb, because that he is conscious about his disability, physical disability. And he reveals here that means on the surface level, means as we have discussed in previous class, that he was at the surface level, it seems that he doesn't have any problem with the with his disability, but actually he has. That he is conscious enough that he is a disabled person. He does not have the real leg, rather he has a tin leg. Now Derry asked, "When it came off, did it?" Means he mean to say that when it came off, then when his leg was separated, did he feel pain at that time? "Certainly," Mr. Lamb said. "Definitely at that time that he felt pain." And Derry, "And now, I mean, where the tin stops at the top?" And now he says, he asks that where the tin stops at the top. And now means, does it pain still? Then Mr. Lamb said that now and then. Sometimes it pains in wet weather, especially in wet weather when it is raining. Is at that time that he feels pain, and it doesn't signify. But even though he is trying to hide his pain, and he says that but means I don't mind it. He doesn't mind it, and he doesn't give much importance to that. Derry, "Oh, that's something else they all say." Now once again Derry has taken that on his own personality. He had related that matter to himself and says that, "Look at all those people who are in pain and brave and never cry and never complain and don't feel sorry for themselves." And now he says that this is what people say to me in order to console me. And he says that sometimes people also say to me that, "Look at all those people that who are in pain, means there are so many people in this world who are in pain, and but they are brave enough because they never cry and never complain. They did not have any complaint with their disability, with their pain, with their sufferings, and don't feel sorry for themselves. And even though they never showed any displeasure, and they did not complain about his life, and they never feel sorry. I haven't said that, but Mr. Lamb had taken on himself that matter, and he said that he never talked like that, he never said like that. But Daddy says that, and think of all those people, means he carried on, he did not stop, rather he went on, and he said that and people also say that think of all those people worse off than you, means there are so many people that who are worse than you, who are in worse condition than you even, and they also think you might have been blinded, and also in order to console me they give examples of some other people that who are suffering from different kind of disabilities, and they say that you might have been blinded. There are so many people who are blind, who are born deaf, so you could also have been blind like them, or you could also have born deaf, or you have to live in a wheelchair, you could have been completely paralyzed with your legs, and you could have been on the wheelchair, or be deaf, you could also have been mad, and you in your head, and dribble, and you could also dribble, means that people used to, in order to console him, in order to show sympathy towards him, in order to convince him to lead his life, whatever he has got with his ugly face, all that, he means the people give examples to some other people that you are better than others who are blind, who are deaf, who are mad, and who are that on wheelchair. Then Mr. Lamb said that, and that's all true and you know it, but still that Mr. Lamb said, yes, that is the reality, because everything is true, whatever they call, whatever they talk like that, if they talk like that, if they give examples to such kind of people, so definitely you are better than all this such kind of people, and you know it well also. And Derry said that it won't make my face change, and their such kind of speeches will not make bring any change in my face, still I will look ugly. That he was obsessed, obsessed by his ugliness. He does not want to come out from it, it seems. And do you know, one day a woman went by me in the street. I was at a bus stop. Now that he also tells a story to Mr. Lamb, that an incident which happened with him, and he says that do you know that one day what happened, that a woman went by me in the street, I was at a bus stop. While he was at the bus stop, a woman was passing nearby him, and she was with another woman, and there was also another woman with her, and she looked at me, and she said, and when she looked at me, means at his face, and she whispered to another woman, to her, she means that woman to look at face, at his face that she whispered, she told to another woman, she was talking to another woman, that only I heard her. And he told that nobody else heard because she was whispering, she was talking slowly. So only he could hear her saying to other woman, she said that, look at that, that's a terrible thing. Now see, students, that this example that is very important for you, please mark it as an important statement. And he said that, and she said that, one woman was talking to another about Derry's ugly face, and she said to her that, look at that, that's a terrible thing, means that is, his face is very terrible, and that's a face only a mother, that's a face only a mother could love, and that is such kind of face, that is a, such a bad face that nobody else can love except to his mother. And why he was telling this? Because such kind of talk, such kind of harsh and cruel comment hurts him a lot, and this is one of the reason, that's why he is withdrawn and defiant. And so Mr. Lamb said that, so you believe everything you hear? Then, you know, Mr. Lamb is a very matured person, and he could understand because he was a sensitive boy, he was just 14 and he was very sensitive. Everything he takes at his heart, everything he takes at his heart. So that was his problem, that's why he was filled with negativity, and he does not have that kind of maturity which Mr. Lamb has. And then Mr. Lamb says that, so you believe everything you hear, then means, it means that you believe everything whatever you hear. Derry said it was cruel, but even he feels hurt because it was a very cruel remark from her, very harsh remark from her about his personality, about his face. Mr. Lamb, maybe not meant as such, just something said between them. And then that he tried to explain him that the way you have taken means, may it not be said to think that, and just something said between them, and it is a general talking between them, but you had taken so deeply, and it is also possible that it may be its meaning will not be so deep as you had taken it, its meaning should not be that much negative as you have taken. Derry, only I heard, but even though he told that, means whatever she told to her, means only I heard, and that's why I took it so seriously and so painful. Then Mr. Lamb, and is that the only thing you ever heard anyone say in your life? And he told that only that much, only such kind of things you have ever heard that someone told to me, means only negative things, that the only thing ever heard anyone say in your life. Have you heard only negative things, which such kind of things which someone told in your life, means is there not any positive thing you have heard from anyone? He meant to say, Derry, oh no, I have heard a lot of things. Rather, he said that, no, not only that much, rather that I have heard a lot of things from people about me. And Mr. Lamb, so now you keep your ears shut. Now he advised him not to listen such kind of cruel and harsh remarks. Rather, for such kind of things, such kind of negative and pessimistic remarks, he should keep his ears shut. And Daddy, you're peculiar and you say peculiar things. You ask questions I don't understand. And then he told that you don't take that matter in such a negative way, in such a, you know, painful way, because you are different and you say peculiar things. You also talk unique things, different things, and you ask questions I don't understand. And because the kind of questions you ask, that I don't understand, means the way Mr. Lamb was talking to him, the way Mr. Lamb was treating to him, behaving to him, because he was taking him normally. He never tried to show any kind of sympathy towards him. And that's why that Derry say that you are different, because you are talking in a different manner. And Mr. Lamb, I like to talk, have company. Now, this is another example, students. You can also see that this is another example of positive attitudes towards life by Mr. Lamb. He says that I like to talk to the people, I like to have a company of human beings, I like to be in company of human being. And you don't have to answer questions, you don't have to stop here at all, the gates open. And then he says that this is my nature, that I love to talk to the people, I'm always in search of human beings company. But you don't have to answer questions, but you are not compelled to answer my questions. You don't have to stop here. If you don't want, you don't need to stop here, because gate is always open, you can go outside. Yes, but Derry, you know, tried to understand him and his feelings, and he says yes, but means he wanted to say something more. But meanwhile, Mr. Lamb said that I have hive of bees behind those trees over there, and some hear bees and they say bees buzz. Now, students, always that, because this is a very important question from this chapter, that what is that both are suffering, both Derry and Lamb are suffering with physical disabilities, but they were poles apart in thinking, means their thinking was absolutely different. One has positive attitude, another has a negative attitude. Elaborate, if you will have to give, and remember, this is important question. And such kind of questions, if you will have to, you will have to answer, then you can give such kind of examples, that how Mr. Lamb's attitude towards life is positive. And even that, if you will have to write the character sketch of Mr. Lamb, if even then you can give such kind of examples in order to enrich your answer. And remember, students, it is always better to pick the examples from the text. Now, here we can also see that another example of positive attitude adopted by Mr. Lamb, when he says that I have a hive of bees behind those trees over there. And now he says to Derry that over there, there are some trees. On those trees, that hive of bees are there, and some hear bees and they say bees buzz. Bees who make those hive, and some people, when they hear those bees, and they can call it buzzing, because those bees produce some buzzing sound. And he says that some people, after hearing their sound, they can say that they are buzzing, means their sound is irritating to them. But when you listen to bees for long while, they hum, and hum means sing. But If you listen them carefully for a longer period of time, then you can feel that actually their sound, their buzzing sound is not so irritating as some people think. Rather, they are humming, means they sing. There is a beauty, means it is soft, it is a sweet sound, and like singing. And I hear them singing, my bees, and he says that when I hear, I feel that they sing. This is the difference of opinion, means same kind of sound may be irritating to someone, but that same bee's sound may be like a sweet song to someone like Mr. Lamb. All this depends upon our opinion, depends upon our thinking, depends upon our attitude and perspective. And why did he say that? He just wanted to motivate him to change his thinking, to change his opinion towards life and people, and be positive and daily. But I like it here. I came in because I liked it. When I looked over the wall, and then that it seems that somewhere that his attitude is going to be changed, and his it seems that Mr. Lamb's speech makes a deep impression on him. And he says that, but I like it here. And he told that, means I like this place. I came in because I liked it. I came in the garden because I liked it. And when I looked over the wall, and he says that when he looked over the wall, he saw the garden. So means he liked this place, and that's why he came here. Mr. Lamb, if you had seen me, you would not have come in. And he told that if when you came, there was no one here, but at that time, if you would have seen me here in the garden, you would never have come. Then Daddy, no, means he denied. But Mr. Lamb said that no, means that is the reality. And Jerry, it would have been trespassing. Trespassing means illegal entry, means entry without permission. And then Jerry said that it would have been a trespassing. Trespassing means my entry was illegal, would have been illegal. Then Mr. Lamb, oh, that's not why. Then he told that, means he did not mean that. And now means he didn't mind for that. He and Derry, that I don't like being near people. Now he reveals himself before Mr. Lamb and says that he doesn't like being near people. He doesn't like to mix up with the people. And when they stare, when I see them being afraid of me. And why he doesn't like to be with the people, to be among the people? Because when they stare means they when they look at him, especially on his ugly face, burnt face, when I see them being afraid of. And then that he realizes, Jerry realizes, when they people look at his face, they become afraid, they become scared. Mr. Lamb, you could lock yourself up in a room and never leave it. Now that in order to convince him, that Mr. Lamb is going to give another example. And he says that you could lock yourself up in a room and never come. It means you can also do that. In that case, if you don't want to mix up with the people, don't want to face the people, then you can lock up yourself in a room and There was a man, and now he tells a story. Remember, student, this is very important that such kind of examples you can give in your answer if it is required. And he says that there was a man. From here, this story is important in order to motivate him to change his attitude towards his life from negative to positive. He says that there was a man who did that. Means there was a man who locked him up into a room, and he says that why he locked himself in a room, because he was afraid. You see that he was afraid of everything. He was afraid of everything in this world. And that further he says that everything in this world, he says that a bus, he was thinking that a bus might run over him. While he will walk on the road, a bus might run over him. Or a man might breathe deadly germs into him, and he was feeling danger from a man while he was talking. If he will talk to someone, so might be that deadly breath germs come into him. And or a donkey might have kicked him to death, and while he walks from near a donkey, it means a donkey can kick him and he could be died. Or lightning might strike him down, or if he walks alone, that he could be killed by the lightning. Or he might love a girl, and girl would leave him. And even he does not want to love a girl, because that he was afraid that she could teach him, cheat him and leave him, and in that case that he would be depressed, and he might slip on a banana skin and fall. And even if he walks alone, that he could slip from the banana skin. And that he was also thinking that the people who saw him would laugh at their heads off. And when that people see him falling from the banana skin, that they could laugh at, and he could feel humiliated. So because of all these things, means he had developed a negative attitude towards life, and he does not take anything positive in the life, and there was a danger of his life. Means he was always afraid of everything when he come out of his room. So he went into this room and locked the door. And after that, what happened? Since he was so much afraid of everything, so he did not want to come out of his room, so he went and locked himself completely inside the room and locked the door and got into his bed and went into his bed and stayed there, considering that he was absolutely safe in his room forever. Then Derry had the curiosity that what happened after that. Means he asked, did he stayed there in his room forever? That Mr. Lamb, for a while, not forever, rather for a while, for some times only. And then Derry, then what happened? Then Mr. Lamb told that a picture fell off the wall onto his head and killed him. And then after what happened? He was afraid of everything in the world. He was afraid of dying. That's why he was not coming out of his room. He had locked himself. But what happened? That unfortunately, a picture fell off the wall. A picture fell from the wall onto his head and killed him, and he was killed. Derry loves a lot, and after listening such a story, it seems funny to him that, and he laughed. And you see, but you still say peculiar things, and even though even then that he says that, Derry says that, still you are saying peculiar things, you are saying the things, different things. Peculiar to someone, but Mr. Lamb says that it could be peculiar to someone, it could be different, unique to someone. And now, students, for today I think that time is over, so I'm going to stop here. And now you can see that there are two questions, means earlier there was one question, and then here on this page this is a question, read and find out under this column. And do you think all this will change Derry's attitude towards Mr. Lamb? Still that we have not read that much, whether means we have not concluded the play to know that what happened, whether Derry's attitude was changed or not. But even though on the basis of this much, whatever you have studied, that you can guess that what would have happened. Whether do you think all this will change, where you know Derry's attitude would have been changed after meeting Mr. Lamb or not? You can guess and you can give your answer. So attempt this answer in 30 to 40 words. Students, remember, every time it may not be possible that I would have reminded you every time that you will have to do this question, you will have to do this question, but you remember that whenever you find that any of the question from the part which has already been explained, and these answers, remember students, you will have to write in 30 to 40 words each only. And then later on, when that story will be finished, we will discuss long answer type questions as well. So for today students, that we are going to stop here. That's all for today, and in our next session we will study the remaining part of the play. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.